Here's part of the proof that the missing, hidden, original 13th Amendment really happened and is still really law in the United States. State of New Hampshire. I, Brian Nelson Buford, archivist for the state of New Hampshire, having been duly authorized by the Secretary of State William G. Gardner to authenticate copies of records and papers kept by the Department of State, do hereby certify that the following and heretofore attached, consisting of 3 pages, are true copies of the original document on file at the Division of Archives and Records Management. Now here is, this is not a copy, this is an original certificate here. This is the gold seal of the state of New Hampshire. Behind it, we have the record from the Journal of the House of Representatives for the state of New Hampshire, dated here December 9th, 1812, 200 years ago. And it reads here very easily, Journal of the House. The committee appointed to take into consideration certain laws and resolutions passed by the legislatures of Georgia, North Carolina, Tennessee, Virginia, and Vermont, and other documents accompanying the same report, etc. The resolves exhibited and they further reported that it is, in their opinion, noticed expedient to adopt or approve the other proposed amendments to the Constitution of the United States, which report was accepted, whereas His Excellency the Governor of this state has laid before the General Court a resolution passed by the Congress of the United States in the words following, to wit, resolved by the Senate and the House of Representatives of the United States of America in Congress assembled, 2/3 of both houses occurring, and here again you see the date, December 9th, 1812. In the November session, the houses occurring that following the section be submitted to the legislatures of the several states, which, when ratified by the legislatures of the 3/4 of the states, shall be valid and binding as part of the Constitution of the United States. If any citizen of the United States shall accept, claim, receive, or retain any title of nobility or honor, or shall, without the consent of Congress, accept and retain any present pension, office, or emolument of any kind whatever from any emperor, king, prince, or foreign power, such person shall cease to be a citizen of the United States and shall be incapable of holding any office, trust, profits under them or either of them. Therefore, resolved by the Senate and the House of Representatives in General Court convened, that the foregoing amendment proposed by Congress to the Constitution of the United States be, and the same is hereby, on the part of this state, agreed to, ratified, and confirmed, and be it further resolved that His Excellency the Governor be requested to transmit copies of the foregoing resolution to the President of the Senate and the Speaker of the House of Representatives in the United States and to each of our senators and representatives in Congress and to each of the governors of the several states. And then it goes on to another thing. But on the back of these, we have the statement in red ink. I do hereby certify the copy of this sheet and the copy of the original document and file at the Division of Archives and Records Management, State of New Hampshire, January 12th, and signed here by Brian Nelson Buford. Same thing on the other copy of these pages. And this, ladies and gentlemen, this, what we have before us here, this is clearly part of the evidence that the amendment, the one we know as the 13th Amendment, was really the 14th Amendment. This was the original, now hidden 13th Amendment, ratified by Tennessee, North Carolina, Georgia, New Hampshire, way back in December and earlier of 1812, and was part of the reason the British invaded us, because basically we had said to them, your barristers, your lawyers, and those that hold an oath to the Great Britain, you're not even a U.S. citizen, so you can't be judges in America, you can't hold any public office at all. This has been hidden from the American people now for over 150 years now, 200 years after New Hampshire passed this resolution. This became the original 13th Amendment and was republished. And retired police officer Tom Dunn, David Dodge, discovered this in New Hampshire, an original constitution. And this relates to the interview I did about a year ago with Alfred Adask near Utopia, Texas. So what this means is that all the judges that hold office, all the lawyers that belong to a bar association, bar stands for British Admiralty Registry, or British Accreditation Registry, bar. So any member of the bar, anybody who claims they have an honor, and just when someone says, I can be a judge or I can be a member of the court system, but you can't, that is in effect claiming an honor, making you unequal. This amendment was passed specifically and precisely to make all American citizens equal, to make sure that every court position was open to election and holding by anybody, not just lawyers, not just bar associations. Because they had four bar associations out of London back in these days. We're talking 200 years. This has been hidden ever since Abraham Lincoln, also a lawyer, was president and signed and declared the emancipation of slaves in America during the American Civil War, and he renamed that the 13th Amendment. Nevertheless, from 1812 to 1860, many, many states published versions of the Constitution with 13 amendments before the Anti-Slavery Act. This is amazing. And there isn't a lawyer in the land that's going to want to believe this, and they don't want you to know about it. Because if you knew about this, and you knew what the common law was, you would understand the common law protects you. The statutory law and all the other kinds of laws that they try to drag you and get you to accept as jurisdiction is in effect gutting your rights, destroying your rights.